Tja, Axel, who wants to live forever? Who dares to love forever? You're the one who lived the longest in America, so I will speak in American with you, because I'm here to make some changes, and us all speaking one language is one of the changes. And you are... Let me talk about now, and then I go back a little bit, because you have created a life for yourself that has a lot to do with what I'm doing as well, because you are repairing cars and in such a wonderful way that's unique on Earth. And I feel this is the new way of living life, so you are being guided, and I believe that you don't know this. And maybe you do, because we lived in the same family, and I probably know least of you, like of your childhood, because I left for America when you were 12 years old, and up until then we were like this, you know, we were really, really close. And you know, when you needed comfort, when you needed a hug, when you, you know, needed to be held or so, you came to me, and it felt natural, because you know, I felt so alone in our family. And so, you know, when that happened, that made me feel good, and I felt really close. And you know, it broke my heart when I left. I remember that, to leave you there. So you grew up there, and I know that horrible things happened to you. You shared some of them. I don't know if there was more. I know that when I left, you know, our parents, they built Hüttenbusch, and you were 12 years old. You still needed to go to school, and of course from Hüttenbusch it was way too long. And then, you know, Toby, he moved into Horn, and you grew up with them. And I know that they treated you like shit, and you know, they it was like a dictatorship, you know. And I know that I did things too that weren't right, you know. But never like what they did. Now it breaks my heart, you know. It hurts me so, because there's nothing. It hurts me that we don't have a relationship. I really don't know what happened. I know that you then came to America to help us, and you were always the one filling the holes in our family. That hurts me so much. Sorry. All right, because this is not what I want to find a way that we start talking about our feelings, because I believe that you know, you're hiding from your feelings. You have no relation, but I don't know, maybe now you have a relationship with the woman, because last time I rang at your door, it was the woman, you know, you talked to, so I was happy about that. And I know that I did something, you know, and I was derailed, totally derailed as a child as well, because, you know, there was so too much sexuality in our family, you know, too much nudity. I didn't want to show myself, and you know, our father, he forced me in a way, you know, by laughing at me, like if I didn't dry myself off in the morning naked in front of him. He said, well, don't you think I never saw a naked woman before? What's the matter with you? You know, you're locked up like my mother, and you know, she was verklempt, and you know, you know what he said about women, you know, and I was a woman, or going to be a woman, and I didn't want to be like the ones he didn't like. But then there was nothing really that he liked about women, and yet you know, the ones that he was with, you know, there was like a love-hate relationship. And even with our mother, I mean, you must remember this, you know, how many times he sat there in his chair and he said, oh, you know, give me a hug, and then our mother never did, you know. He had to really force it. Oh, you know, why aren't you nice once to me, and then why don't you hug me once? Nothing. It was just like, you know, pushing him away. And you know, that hurt me, because I'm the only, and I'm the only daughter, the only girl in the family. So it may be difficult also for you to see that you know, I have issues with my mother, you know, where you may have had issues with your dad, because, you know, that's our role models. And I'm the only woman in the family, so, you know, my role model was my mother, and I didn't want to be like her. Sorry, you know, there's a lot of good things in her, and I learned a lot of things that in the world that I was going into to grow up as an adult, they didn't serve me then. They didn't help me, you know, like, you know, learning how to knit and crochet and sew and you know, like all this stuff that people did in the Middle Ages, so to speak, you know, that didn't serve me in the world to become, you know, a successful career woman. So, you know, and I admit, you know, I took all that, but it didn't help me. It didn't get me into a career, didn't get me anywhere. Now, you know, the paradox in this is that I feel that our world is changing, that we're actually coming back to that. And because I have all these things that I learned, this is how I created, how should I say, everything that I feel I was guided, you know, to use to show how this higher power that our father always said, you know, I have the direct, ich habe den direkten Draht zum lieben Gott, I have the direct connection, you know. He felt that he was guided, and I'm here to share this with everybody, how this thing communicates with me, so everybody may learn, you too, everybody. And so you know, you were in America for 6 years, I think, about, and you know, you first came to take care of Annika. So then I was working and, you know, created the company, the agency of Richard Boas in New York. So, you know, I worked with Michelle for a year, and you took care of Annika, and I was very, very thankful for that. And we got along then, and then you went back, and then things got bad, and then you returned, and then you worked with Michelle. And I remember there was a time, you know, in that year where I worked there, that Michelle went here on a business trip, and he was here for 2 weeks in Germany, and I was alone in the company for 2 weeks. I took care of the company for 2 weeks, and I remember our dad kept on telling me, "Boy, I wish you would run this company. It is so smooth, you know, to work with you." And of course, you know, I'm his daughter, you know, it's I know how, or I knew how he was thinking. And won't talk too much about the crimes that we committed, because I feel that whatever we did, everybody else is doing, you know, to be able to live in this system, and this is why I'm here, to crash it. And you know, I don't know how you feel about that, but behind people's back in our family, you know, things are said that are really cruel, and you are treated as the gay member of the family. And how do you feel about that? I know that, you know, I had my thoughts on that also, and I don't believe that you're gay. What I believe is that you're afraid to face your true feelings of your childhood, of the abuse that you went through, and you know, you are very close to our mother, because she's alone now, and you were close, and she was close with you. Like, you know, she felt guilty that she didn't have enough time with the rest of us, because we came one after the other, and you were the last, and you know, so we were okay already, and then she focused on you. And sometimes, you know, it can be too much also. So I'm not trying to take your mom away from you. I'm trying to make you feel you, so you can be independent. And if our mom is hurting because of our dad's death, then that's her problem. It is not for you to step in and be her husband, her substitute husband. You're not helping her, and you're certainly not helping yourself. I do love you a lot, Axel, because I feel like there is something we had that was special, and there's something that I have special with every brother. And you know, Holger was always there when I lived at home and I had a bad time. He would always listen. He was the only one who did. And with Toby, I also had a very close relationship. I mean, Toby always wanted me to be okay too, so, you know, he gave me little crumbs, you know, like, you know, why don't you try this and why don't you try that? So he meant well. But then for Toby was also like, you know, I need to be above you. I need to be better than you. So if you'd like just here, you know, it's okay. If you are a little bit less than here, then I'm there for you. But you will never be like me, because this is what he was taught by our parents. And this is my side of the story. I'm not saying that I'm right. This is how I perceived our family. Now, the only way for us to ever have a chance to come together is if you share your side, your feelings of how you feel our family functioned. And I learned, you know, with a lot of professional help that our family was dysfunctional. And I'm sorry about that. You know, that's how it is. And I believe that 99% of families right now are dysfunctional, because we live in a world system based on fear. Where is there the love? You know, how can you love honestly if you always need to watch out that something's gonna happen to you? You know, you're gonna be hurt. This is what I'm here to change, and you know that love, that change starts in the family. And I have tried that for, you know, so many times. And you were in my family, in, you know, that I created with Annika and Florian. And you know, you have no children. And I know I made my set of mistakes. I also know that I didn't make any more or any less than any mom on earth. And so you know, the things that you said to me about the mistakes that I made with Annika and Florian, I'm sorry. I just don't accept that. That's not, you have no right whatsoever. Create your own family and then we talk. That's about the only anger I have against you. Because, you know, you said that Florian, he just turned out to be like his dad, and you know, they're all stupid because they don't do what you want them to do. A little bit easy. That's not okay. And this is where I know that our relationship, you know, fell apart totally. And I know that you have a lot of anger. I also swallowed a lot of that, and that I would never be able to accept anymore. So we need to take responsibility for our own lives and share our feelings and, you know, live our own lives and connect every now and then and see, you know, how you're doing, how's life for you, is everything going well. And I believe that with what you're doing in your life right now, that has a future with what I'm here to bring to everybody. And I hope that we will find a way, because I do love you. And I know love, the word love in our family is Chinese, and maybe we can translate it, learn to translate it. All the best to you, Axel. You're close to my heart, and my whole family is, you know. Everybody, and we all have our problems, me too, you know, and I'm willing to admit to that, but not like, you know, you're sick and out. That's I don't even know how you can. I could never do that, but okay, that's me. All right, all the best. I hope we find a way. I'm here, you know, where to reach me, and